I gotta go my own way.
What about us? What about everything we've been through?
What about trust?
You know I never wanted to hurt you.
What about me?
A Raven Simone, and like That's a Raven was like huge for me. So I would like go to school and act out the scenes that I saw like the previous night. So for me, the inspiration came from like just funny women. I am truly just trying to be my most authentic self, and that's gonna shift and that's gonna change as I gain more interest or get older and all these different things. What makes me the most happy is that where I am right now, people are able to relate to and people are able to find things to say, like I found the confidence in myself because of something that your character did. I think as an actor, those weren't really things I ever thought about, because I was literally just doing the grind and trying to get to where I wanted to be. And then all of this other stuff of people relating to you, I mean, that's like the biggest perk of all, right? I mean, sure. Every day you like wake up and you're like, oh my gosh, what am I today? Who am I today? But I think it all just goes back to finding the way like people have reached out and say, like have said, your character gives me inspiration. I'm also doing the same thing to other people that I loved and watched. I try to let those thoughts come in and then quickly release, because at the end of the day, nobody has anything figured out. So really we can't look to one person to say like, that is perfection. I mean, some people have gotten close and Beyonce's sure. amazing.
The closest, if
yeah.
anything.
But of course, like at the end of the day, like, you know, she's gonna have the same problems all of us are gonna have. And I try to let those like intrusive thoughts just quickly come and then leave, because they don't really serve you and you just gotta do your own thing. Yeah. Cause I was a theater kid. I wanted to be like in charge of everything. I wanted to like direct all the shows. And that's really all I cared about as a teenager. I was like, what show are we doing next season? Like, what role do I want? And so, and I think that's very similar to Carlos. And so if anything, it helped me really identify that I really was like a theater kid in like a small farm town. Cause when you're like the only one, it's like a little isolating and you're like, okay, like I have this like secret thing that I like to do, but I have to like pretend that like I also have an interest in high school football to like also, so it's a chance to hang out with my friends. Do you
Absolutely.
Know what I mean? When I had no interest. Sometimes it'll slip out, but I'd say like 9 times out of 10, it's like, it's being filtered through like a, maybe that's not the best thing to say right now. Yeah. Life is what you make it. And at some point you're gonna be out on your own. You're gonna be making your own decisions. You're gonna get to do the things that you want to do. Like I said, I grew up very religious. So like, of course, like, you know, the things I had interest in, like any type of like glitter type thing, anything that was considered for girls was just like a big no-no. And so now in my adult life, I feel like I'm like trying to like make up for everything.
Absolutely.
And it's just kind of silly, because at the end of the day, it's just things that like make you happy. So I just say like, it gets better. And like, at some point you're going to get to like be in the driver's seat and make the decisions for yourself.
Yeah.
And when you do, it's going to be amazing. It makes me want to roll my eyes. We got a lot of comments that were just like, stop ruining my childhood. It's like, this is going to ruin your entire childhood. Being like High School Musical being made into a TV series is going to ruin your entire childhood. So whatever, get over it. It's kind of crazy that I identified as Latino, and then one day I woke up and all of a sudden like someone else has decided that now I'm Latinx. I had never heard the term before. No one in my family uses the term. No one I grew up with, and I went to a high school where about like 60% of the students are Latino. So it is kind of crazy now that like I do, when we do like press and interviews, like that's what I'm referred to as. I'm like, who decided this?
Yeah.
I don't know if I like it.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It's gonna be tricky. And I just hope I'm as like on the side of progression as possible.
Yeah.
I'm trying to get better at meeting people where they're at. And unfortunately, we are still so behind when it comes to like people expressing themselves and stuff.
Yeah.
And like even now, like we meaning like me and Joe being the face of these like openly gay characters, we get a lot of flack too. And like if something is posted, it's like just the most disgusting, small-minded comments that you could think. When we met, I didn't like say, hi, nice to meet you, I'm Frankie, I'm gay.
Right.
Do you know what I mean?
Right. So there's something so refreshing about that.
People should play roles that are their own age. Nobody believes that a 30-year-old actor is 16 on screen. I don't believe that. I don't believe it. I think it's all about chemistry and it's about essence and best person for the role. If this is the biggest like burden you're gonna carry or what age people are playing on screen, I think you've gotta find a hobby or something because it's like, it's so like minor that it's like, it's a moot point. Cancel the Real Housewives franchise. We do not need to glorify this behavior. Excuse me.
For anyone who doesn't know, Frankie's Instagram bio very proudly states that he is a future Real Housewife, so I know this one hits close to home.
No, do not cancel it, because then I will have nothing to talk about. The hottest take I have right now are celebrity relationships. I don't care. I don't care how long they've been dating. I don't care when they broke up. I love Jennifer Lopez, idol. But if I never had to hear about like her like marriage ever again, I'd be just fine. Be yourself, express yourself, have fun. You're this age at this specific time for like one moment in your life and it's gonna change and evolve. Clock in for the journey.
Imagine having everything we ever dreamed. Don't you want it?
Maybe.
Can't you see it?
Kind of. Just to say congratulations.
Thank you.
I wish I could have been there, but I can't wait to see the videos.
Thank you so much. That is so kind. Am I gonna hold them? We're all here on this earth together and you're gonna see people eventually, whether it's in media or at the airport or at the mall. The more you're exposed to it and you see how everyone is on their own journey, living their own life and following their own dreams and their passions, like we're all out here living our lives. And I think it's important to see that other people exist.
Absolutely.
That might be different than you. I grew up very Catholic. We went to church every Sunday. I could never pay attention. I was always just sort of like looking at the structures. I was just always looking for something else to focus on than whatever they were like droning on about. But I loved the music in church. I think I might be a little gay. Like, and they had a moment of just like, you know, because of the religion and what they had grown up believing and practicing. Well, that was a little bit of a rough moment, but they've come so far. They've had such a journey and they couldn't be more supportive now. So it's been great. And the siblings have always had my back. Okay. Yeah. I feel like in middle school was when I first heard the term people pleaser, and it was from a friend group that I was like sort of having a falling out with at the time. You know, we have phases of friend groups, right? And I remember hearing the term people pleaser and I just thought, and I was like, oh, that would be me. That would be me. I am definitely always trying to make sure everyone's happy and pleased with me. I feel like in high school, probably it was when I started like really talking about it with certain friends that maybe were catching on to things and maybe prying a little bit. But I dated women for a long time. And I actually like look back on those relationships with such a feeling of like, that wasn't like a phase. It wasn't a thing that I was putting on or masking my queerness. I always say like, I identify as bisexual because those were very real relationships that had very real feelings and real weight to them in my Absolutely. Life at that time. It was what love is to me right now. And that's my definition of love right now. And
that's a great answer.
Right. So that's what love was to me then. And right now I think it's interesting. I often am really thought of as gay, right? I'm playing a gay character, dating a boy, and that's fine, whatever. I am gay, yes, I'm dating a boy, but I'm also bisexual, I'm also queer. It's a spectrum.
Do you feel like you've been put in a box?
In some way, but I'm like, you know, I am who I am. I'm not really crazy on like trying to define exactly what I am.
For sure.
It's really, I'm just like, I'm Joe. So I could have never dreamed of it, you know? I was going to school for theater. I thought I was gonna just go and like work in theater. Once this all happened, it was a whirlwind and I understood the weight of it. And obviously it was like, well, yeah, but I'm gonna do it because I identify with this character and I'm proud to tell these stories and be a part of that representation. They obviously are capitalizing on it. They want everyone to know what they're achieving, and as they should. I think it's so important and so amazing what we're doing and how far we've come. At the end of the day, like, we're all just people.
Yeah, totally.
we all want love. We all want to be accepted. We all want to be ourselves. I don't really have anything that I would like to go back and like redo. I feel like I've always just tried to be myself and do what I do. And I had such a good time in high school. I loved dating those girls. I loved the roles I was playing. It was great. It was awesome. I was watching back some videos of like me talking on the stage or like me dancing on the stage and singing or the way I was like moving. And I was like, wow, I'm pretty fruity. Like he's pretty gay. I get it. I understand. It's a lot. Frankie makes fun of me. It's a cult. Go Blue. They're passionate. We're passionate about what we do. And I think at the end of the day, that's why the program is so successful. The people that come from that program are killing it, like in all levels. If you want to knock them down, that's probably just your own jealousy. Sure. I'm a firm believer that what you put out comes back to you. And I think if you are nice to people, it's good karma. It's good karma. You have to be nice to people. Be you and be nice. I get it. We all have our opinions about things and we wanna let them be known and share our hot takes. That's what this show is all about, right? But like when I see like negative talk about someone's art or someone's, you know, what someone's putting out there, it's really disappointing because like I said, we're all doing our best. So like root for each other. We're all here just squirrels trying to get a nut is absolutely what Frankie always says.
It's amazing.
But it's true.
This week, a hot new bombshell enters the villa. Don't call me up.
I'm going out tonight, feeling good. I'm Mabel, I'm 25. Frankie and Joe, hello. Welcome back on POVs.
We're both the babies of our families, so I feel like there's an energy of like, you have no choice but to go with the flow. So we're definitely like go with the flow, but also being the baby, we're probably the most spoiled. And so like, we do treat ourselves.
But we're good at, I feel like, letting one of us take the lead and the other one following.
Yeah.
I feel like we share the balance pretty well.
Yeah.
Frankie's honestly been someone who's helped me to understand like better boundaries for myself in terms of like what I choose to consume on my phone, like and choose to like let get into my head. I guess it's not really a disagreement, but like I feel like you've been like, don't look at that stuff. You're helpful in that way. But that's a disagreement because you don't look at that stuff.
Well, I'm a firm believer, don't read the comments. Ever, 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 ever.
I want to know what people are saying.
I don't want to know what people are saying.
So that's how you're different.
For the most part, we're always on the same page in terms of like where we want to be, where we want to go, what we want to do.
We had a fight the other day though. I was telling you something.
Oh, and, yeah.
And you didn't really care, but he was trying to just like engage because I was talking and then like, he was getting details wrong as he was asking me about it. And I was like, no, it's this and this. And he was like, well, I don't even care. I was just.
He was reading it. What happened is he was reading a text message out loud, but he started reading it out loud halfway through the text message. So he had all the information. I got half the information and we were just walking. So I was like, wait, I was just trying to understand.
So then for me to make him feel stupid about it,
I was like,
he was upset by that.
I was like, and then I was like, I didn't even care about the text message.
Yeah.
So I was like, I didn't care to have the conversation.
But you clarified that.
But we clarified.
Yeah,
right?
We clarified.
Had a moment of silence and then later we talked about it and it was great. We moved on.
Sometimes that's what it takes, right? Just yeah. Taking a beat.
And that is honestly how it always goes.
Yeah.
It's like you just have to give yourself your space, mm-hmm. Let it breathe, and come back whenever you're all collected and ready to move on.
I think what I'm attracted to is someone who's like a go-getter and someone who's gonna like, you know, go after their dreams and like do it and go like 150%. And I would say that's like definitely Joe. And that's like,
ditto.
And you though. So I don't think it's like something that I'm like, they have to have this, but I think it was the thing that I was like, oh, hello.
Yeah. Give each other space on both ends. Do you know what I mean?
Absolutely.
Like,
even though we're similar, we leave room for opposing views.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. And like hear them out. And change a little bit of our own opinions because of each other's views.
Absolutely.
3, 2, 1, HSM TMTS. I mean, come
well,
on.
You're so far, off so to good. A good start.
All right,
start.
Here we go.
Okay, let me hold it.
Oh, sure.
I just would always prefer to move on with kindness than feeling like I put somebody else down just to be right.
I think there's just more room if you're coming from a place of kindness to hear people out and maybe like discover you might not be right about something. But I hate when people are like
righteous.
Yeah, it's like because then it's like such a dead end. Or if you're being kind, like even if it's like the smallest detail, like you could just like choose to forget about whatever that conversation was the next day.
I correct you sometimes. just let me live.
Yeah.
Oof. 3, 2, 1. dogs.
Neither.
Okay, let's unpack that, because the first time I met you, you were telling me all about how you were gonna get a dog, but now you're saying neither.
Okay, I grew up, we always had like 100 animals at one time, like across the entire spectrum. So in my adult life, I don't really feel the need to have an animal. However, my perspective is changing as of recent, especially being here in New York and seeing like all these dogs up close. But I did grow up with a cat, and that was my cat, so I guess
Frankie
cats.
Is a cat.
Oh.
He operates like a cat.
Interesting. Is that new to you?
No, it's not new. Okay. I describe myself as a cat.
In what ways?
Just very loungy. Like, I'll move from one room to, I'll stretch, go to the next room, but only to do the same thing I did in the room before.
Yeah. I think I'm allergic to both cats and dogs, honestly. I think once I had a dog in the house that, you know, your body gets used to the
sure.
allergy or whatever.
Yeah.
But I love dogs.
So is this a point of contention? Like, are you
not
planning
really.
To get a dog?
I think eventually when the time is right. And
here's also the thing. If we had a dog, I would love the dog because it's our dog. I don't want to be around other people's dogs.
There it is.
Depends on the dog.
Because I know my dog would be like, it'd be so cool and chill. And I'd be like, this is the dog. Mm-hmm. But I feel like everybody says that about their dogs. My favorite musical that we share.
We love Legally Blonde.
Legally Blonde is always a good one. We always play Wicked too.
Wicked's always good, but that's so basic.
Legally Blonde. Six, we love.
Six, we love.
We don't, by the way.
Okay.
Just putting
that
out.
This is hypothetical. And let's say you hated cats, but Joe was in it. Would you still go to see it?
Oh my gosh, yes. Of course I would.
Yeah, he would come.
Yeah. Sweet or spicy?
Three, two, one, sweet.
Yeah, you don't really eat spicy food.
I do like spicy foods, but I will always opt for
like
a sweet.
Yeah.
So you took the food route immediately, because I saw in your bio, you
it's
have the word
spicy.
Spicy.
That's why I literally laughed.
Yeah.
I consider myself to be sweet and spicy. Mm. After today, I'm not sure. carry that title. I think people are always shocked that I have like a bit of a opinionated side of like if someone's acting funky, I will give you eyes like, what is going on over there?
Someone's and opening their candy in the movie theater?
Yes. Yes. I'm generally very, very nice,
got
but
it.
I can be spicy.
I'd be more sweet, I think. I think it's 50-50.
It's like a healthy
you're
mix.
Sweet.
Yeah.
You're sweet in general.
Thanks.
But once you get to know him, he can drag you.
But I only drag you if I love you.
True.
Dating on screen or dating in real life? Three, two, one. Dating in real life.
I could have guessed that.
It's weird because it's written for you. Mm-hmm. So it's not really us. They look at us and they see the way we interact and of course like try to write to that, but it's also like they're characters of us, so it's just so separate from the way I view you and me.
It's work and home life, and then but what makes it like I guess like semi just different is that people have a perception of like what we actually might be like based off the show. But for the most part, I think if people like follow us and stuff, they'll definitely get a pieces of our personality and they have a good grasp that we're different than the characters we play. Obviously the love of musicals. Mm-hmm. There was a line in the Quinceañera episode that you say, what do you say, our love for female pop ballads.
Yeah,
I think that is
definitely.
Like
also though very similar dynamics of whenever we're caroling on the doorstep and I do it and then you correct me like,
oh yeah,
that's happened in the real life. Like, not exactly that situation, but where I do something and he's like, "No, that's not what we were doing." Like,
did you rehearse that?
No.
You're saying all of the same answers.
I'm telling you, we see eye to eye on most things. We also always dress the same. We also always order the same thing at the restaurant.
Wow.
It's disgusting.
It's disgusting.
The way we operate in terms of the way we move throughout the house. I like to clean up as I go. Like, you will never find a mess around me. Like, if I'm taking my shoes off, they're being put away as soon as I take them off. Frankie will kick his shoes off and they will lay there until, and he'll throw his bag and he'll throw his keys and he'll throw whatever he was carrying and it will all lay out until he does a full clean sweep later. all my stuff is taken care of right away.
How do you navigate that difference between the two of you?
Patience. No, it's fine. I just had to accept that that's his way. And it's fine. He really does. Once he cleans it up, he really cleans it up.
We're making messes all day, right? All day we make messes. Doesn't it make more sense to do everything at once? So then you're also not forgetting, like, oh, I needed to do this, like, part, like, clean this part of the house. I don't let it, like, build up.
It's even when we get home from trips, I unpack right away and I get it all.
I think that is crazy. You just got back from a trip and the first thing you're going to do is a chore. It's insane. I don't like it.
Psychotic. He's like, I'm going to sit for a second.
Yeah, I'm going to lay.
As a couple?
About like housewives drama sometimes. Stupid.
Sure. Yeah. We have debated the way some people handle situations.
Yeah. But it's a conversation.
Yeah.
It's never.
And we're not confrontational, really.
Are we boring that we just don't have anything?
No. I think that's like one of the, like, my favorite things about us is that, like, we are very similar in a lot of ways and we have, like, similar upbringings and, like, we're close to our families and all those things that, like, help us get along. But I do like that, like, when Joe has a stance and an opinion, he's, like, able to freely state it. I'm able to take it in and think, like, oh, okay, like, it is able to change my mind. Do you know what I mean? And so I think that's why it works too, because
we let each other do our thing.
Yeah.
Being open to change.
Totally.
But I like when I'm unsure about something, I can go to Joe and like, he's gonna give me the most honest opinion that can sway like how I feel about something or how I go into a situation. And I know it's gonna come from a good place.
Same with me. I think it comes back to that last this or that answers, conversations. Mm-hmm. Communication is so key. And hearing each other out. And if we are having an issue, like I said, you give it space and then you come back and you just discuss where each other are at. And if it's actually it at a point where like it's so strong of a disagreement that like you can't move forward, then maybe
break up.
It's just not the right time.
I mean just conversations and communications, because in most cases like a fight or something is all gonna like boil down to miscommunication, how someone meant to say something could be different the way someone received it. And that is one thing I love about Joe, is that like it's gonna be talked about and it's always come from a place of like kindness and love, because that's who he is. And I think it just, that helps.
Beautiful.
I think we're really kind and I feel like we mind our business.
Yeah.
There's no shade to anyone that is publicizing their relationship in such a way, but I like that as much as we are public, because it just is, we still allow ourselves the privacy to like just be us.
In terms of like not exploiting ourselves, I think to have a healthy balance between, because no matter what, our relationship is going to be public. But in terms of like how we operate together and what we choose to share, and what we choose to share is going to be what we choose to share and like what we want to say about us as a couple.
Gibson, where you differ in terms of.
Bus driver, we're doing eye makeup back here. Steady on the road.
People don't know this yet, but we're the best of friends.
We are best friends, and we also have like a handshake.
Yeah, do you want to see it?
It's really cool.
So what are we gonna be?
Camera only, Mark.
Peace out.
Bye.
Say bye.
Zoe Serafini from Pittsburgh. The one and only from Selma, Frankie Rodriguez. Get out here, kid.
Frankie.
Yes?
Dab me up, Frankie. No, dab, like with your hand.
Get out of here.
Give us your best walk. Oh.
Sunny.
I'm scared.
I'm passing the phone to the bougiest of them all.
I'm passing the phone to someone who goes, oh.
Watching the Kids' Choice Awards, so to now be here. It's surreal. We're on the orange carpet.
I know, that's insane.
I still have the picture of the day I was like, that's Isai.
That's fun.
So sassy.
Very.
Documentary. And I want the rest of it so bad. I wish it was a real show.
I do too, honestly. Yeah. There's a lot of juicy stuff in there.
I'm not going to lie.
I feel like we definitely see some of that drama flesh out in the new season. He's a wildcat now.
Oh my gosh.
I should duet with both of you because that I feel like that would break the
hint, 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 hint.
Oh, I think he's
just making things up.
I
don't know.
I'm hinting at producers right now. All Let's make that happen.
All right. Oh, I've revealed that there is the first Seblos duet ever, which is really fun.
Which is a beautiful song, by the way. One of my favorites from the season.
So we have a lot to look forward to.
You could slime anybody from your High School Musical cast. Who would it be?
Dara. She's coming tonight, too.
I'll say Frankie Rodriguez.
Frankie was my first song, and I was like, I know
he'll kill you.
Yeah, he will. Frankie lives, like, too close to me for that, so.
I'll let you handle it.
Yeah, I'll let him
get
it.
And I will.
SpongeBob SquarePants!
Which one you want to
That's the nervous face right there. That's the nervous look.
You know, I'm going to let Joe go first.
Okay.
Just a little, you can just do like a little dip. Just a little dippy dip.
This is truth?
You got the truth? Okay, there we go.
I just need to see the caliber of truth.
But like we can't handle the truth. Oh, there it is.
What's up with this slime?
That's a good one.
It's gooey. It's not particularly sticky.
No,
right.
It isn't.
It's like a little slimy. Yeah.
It's definitely slimy.
It's the boats, too. Unlimited amounts of
food. Thank you guys so much for coming. Ooh. And this is our special parting gift, an entire rotisserie chicken.
That's what I wanted.
Yeah, just add it to your boat.
Unlimited food. This is the unlimited food.
I mean, it's a pretty long show, so here's your snack.
You made it yourself, you said.
We did.
Yes, we did.
It's off to a good start.
We're in a kitchen.
This is okay.
Oh my gosh. Well,
you won't go hungry.
Thank you guys so much.
Get you out of my mind.
Hi. I'm really trying to hurry. I just know I'm gonna come out and Joe's gonna be like, what were you doing in there? I'm gonna be like, I was with my friends, Joe. I was with my friends. Can we see the fit? I have yet to put it on. If I had to go back to school, like, at this, like, time in my life, I would scream. I kind of slayed. I have not seen Red, White, and Royal Blue yet, but when we're all ready for a good laugh, someday, I will show you my audition tape for it. someday. Okay, we have our first special guest of this live.
Wow, totally different vibe in here.
Yeah, it's Beyonce.
Hi, everybody.
Look at Joe. Say hi, Joe. Oh,
I got a heart.
I didn't get a heart.
No, I got one on my head.
Nobody gave me a heart. They've been asking for you.
Aw, hello everybody.
Hi, I thought I was running late. Are you running late too?
We have 9 minutes, right? I should probably go finish getting ready.
Okay.
I'm like mostly ready, but...
Yeah, you look good. Thank you.
I like
your hair.
Thanks.
Your little prince hair.
Okay. You look cute too. Very messy, like cute. Like, you know what I mean, like...
Okay. You look good. You like
no, like yeah, I like the like messy cute.
I like the like not trying.
I like this to be a little messy.
I like that you like are okay looking bad. You know what I mean? I'm just kidding, Joe. Okay. Okay, I'm packing my bag and then I'm honestly ready to go.
I need to go finish then.
Okay.
Well, goodbye. Then, hi everybody. Goodbye.
I'm not going to feel bad about not being ready then because if he's not even ready, if you have school tomorrow, I'm sorry. If you have work tomorrow, good for you.
Oh my god.
I know. It's so Gen Z.
We're right here.
So Gen Z. I'm here with Frankie and Jay.
No more picking fights for something stupid.
You better sing, Kylie. Oh my gosh, you sound amazing.
Oh my gosh,
thank
I also
you
feel like it's come such a long way since you first posted like that little snippet
it
on TikTok.
It has, it really has, like a whole new song.
Today I chose to read Worm Loves Worm. Worm loves worm. Let's be married, says worm to worm. Yes, answers worm. Let's be married. Wait, says cricket. That isn't how it's always been done. Then we'll just change how it's done, says worm. Yes, says worm. And so they were married. Because worm loves worm.
All I know is you're someone I have always known. And I don't even know you now. I wanna hold you close. I don't wanna ever have to let you go.
Suddenly there's sunlight, bright and warm.
Suddenly I'm holding the world in my arms.
Can't bring you down.
That's a song.
Oh, baby girl.
Yeah, eat it.
Eat it.
Eat it.
She is the moment.
Hey, Frankie, how'd you feel about the first act? Frankie? Sorry, does anyone have his agent's number? We want to talk to Frankie. Oh my God.
Okay, somebody asked and it made me laugh. Why is the wall so plain? It's my ceiling. It's not a wall. I guess it is a wall, but it is a ceiling. That's why there's nothing on the wall. But yeah, I do think there should be a lamp there or something, but I'm not a handyman and I'm not about to put a hole in the ceiling. No, thank you. At one of my last apartments, though, the ceiling did cave in. I like air conditioning. And when it's cold, I like a heater. And I don't like anything in between. I like a nice day, but I need to be in like central air. I went to school for musical theater, which if you don't know, is a useless degree. I'm going to a concert soon, but I don't know who it is. Someone Joe likes, but I will be there in full support. I forget about time zones. I wish we were all in the same time zone. Now you're kind of making me think maybe I should go to Joe's show. Everybody's asking where Joe is. Joe is busy ATM. That is short for at the moment. My Spanish is so bad. Like I need to work on it, but it's so bad. But people ask me all the time if I speak Spanish, and I'm like, no, sorry.
Oh my gosh, one song that always gets me going, whether like I'm in a bad mood or I just need like a little lifted, is I Want to Dance with Somebody, Whitney Houston. So that's like, I would say like always amplifies me to be like the best version of myself.
The Inspoken, I was trying to put something together, nothing was working. And then I was like, I literally shot up in my sleep and I was like pink suit, something under, and boots. And so that was the inspiration.
Grease 2,
Schindler's List, Blaine and Kurt on Glee.
I grew up Pentecostal, so
oh, wow.
Yeah, that's the one you're like speaking in tongues and like rolling on the floor.
Yes.
And oh, it's wow. A little alarming to watch now what that experience was, but to think that was very normal as a kid was
so
very funny.
It was,
we probably went to church about 6 days a week, so it was very like immersive. And
you went to church 6 days a week?
Yeah, there wasn't like a church service every day, but there was like a Bible study or like
yes,
a youth group or like, do you know something? So we were just there all the time. Oh. Growing up gay is not something I really thought about. I kind of always knew that path that was set out from the church was just not for me. So I always knew that there was an alternative route that I would take at some point. I just didn't know when that would come. But I guess you could say it was kind of isolating, and not so much in a way that was like, this is just for me to deal with by myself. It was just kind of more, there was no connection to other people or peers growing up. So that was kind of hard, knowing that I had to get along with people and operate a certain way, knowing that, you know, when I went to school, I was gonna operate a completely different way. So like walk on any set is always like a little like, you know, it's foreign territory. But it would be when I had two lines on Modern Family.
Okay.
That was like a very big break for me because, it's iconic. It was obviously, you know, when you're an actor, you do a lot of, when you're starting out, you do a lot of stuff no one has ever heard of or no one will ever see, including yourself sometimes.
Yes.
They just like don't come out.
Yes.
So to be, to get a show that is actually on TV and you can say like the name and people understand it, you're like, oh, okay, this is good. So that was like my big break. And I remember I just got the call and my agent was like, you're moving to Utah. And I was like, oh my God. And I remember just going in for that appointment, just like sitting there, like my eye, like I couldn't even like control my eyes. I was like so excited, but I was crazy excited. I have this like crazy dream that like 10 years from now, I'll just like shift gears and want to become a pop star. So I think.
Okay, yeah.
But I think like, just the continuation of stuff that I'm doing now. I love acting. I love being on stage. I love performing, and I love music. So, I mean, I don't know. I'm so open to everything and kind of just like, you know, seeing where the cards are dealt.
Yeah, like bring it.
I'm ready.
Let's do this.
Yeah, totally.
Well,
I'm also not a dancer. So it is very, it's like foreign territory for me when people are saying like left, right. And I'm just like, and the arms and legs. So it's very confusing for me. But I think in terms of like my own pop star journey, it's just gonna be like a lot of arms and like, just like lift me up. So I'm not too worried about that. I find my pride and my strength, I think in just the freedom to like be myself. And you know, of course, like the inner pop star in me.
How could that go wrong?
Yeah. How could it go wrong?
I found the way. I finally found the way to let things go. The past is there to teach you. Mistakes provide the pain that helps you grow. So I have healed and I have grown. At some point I guess you have to. But I don't wanna face the world on my own. Something has got to start. I am ready to be loved. Someone come steal my heart. I am ready to be loved. I know you'll find me. It takes time. But today I know that
me feel like you're born with it, like the constant need for attention.
she put me in every after school sport that she could possibly think of. And of course I hated all of them.
You're like, I cannot do this.
Yeah. And I wasn't just like bad at them. I was also like there was like an attitude that went with it where I was just like, I'm going to pretend to do this really bad. So like, you don't ever have to like make me come here ever again.
Oh, so you were acting before you were acting.
There you go. Oh yeah. I think most of this career is just living in a fantasy world of like, well, maybe someday. I'm not trying to do homework to do a TikTok. Some kids, like we have a lot of younger kids on the set of High School Musical, and the way they're able to edit in real time and put together,
wild.
I'm like, there's too many buttons already. And I hate sounding like that because I never wanted to sound like, you know, old, but
an old copyright.
I'm like, I just tell me how to record something. Like, they yell action and we like all run in, and this one girl just takes her shirt off and was like, yeah, come on guys. And we were like, okay. And then so we just finished off the scene, but I remember thinking like, is that what people are doing?
Oh my God.
I just thought it was so crazy.
Person you look up to the most?
Oh, my mom.
Give it patience, give it room, when something's bound to bloom and stretch beyond the sky. One small seed can break open like an answer, and all you need, it's here. Inside your head. Oh, you never can know where all you will grow could lead. From one small seed. One small seed. One small seed.
We are so excited to be here for the very first time.
Oh my gosh. And when we were trying to think of what we wanted to sing for you all, we called up our showrunner, Tim Federle, and we asked him, what if we sang a song that no one has ever heard before?
We can't say too much, but it is a Seb and Carlos duet in season 4 of High School Musical, the musical series. Coming to Disney Plus later this year.
Can't say much more than that, but it's called Over Again, and it's by Jaheim Toombs and Matt Martinez. So let's do it. I wish I could turn back time. I don't know how I could be so blind. Oh, there's nothing left to say except I'm sorry. I know that I'm a mess, and you should have nothing less than my whole heart, and it's all yours if you still want me. You deserve happily ever after, and I don't deserve a second chance.
Sometimes you make me mad, sometimes I treat you bad, but you see right through my flaws because you know me. But when push comes to shove, there's only heartbreak because there's love. And all I really want right now is for you to hold.
I want you to hold me.
I know this isn't perfect, but I know you make me better. So let's live inside this moment and forget about forever. And no matter what you say or do, I'll be running back to you over and over again. God, I feel so lucky. I found something that's real, and I'm lost without your love, my love. You taught me how to feel. Yeah, you're my favorite melody. I will love you endlessly. Oh.
over and over and over and over again. All of my life I've been told.
Since you're the status quo, don't let anybody see who you are. Then you came along and suddenly I'm hurt.
Forever's not a fairy tale. I hope you're my forever.
If we fall again, we'll make it through. I'll be there to carry you over and over again.
God, I feel so lucky to have found something that's real. And I'm lost without your love. My love, you taught me how to feel. If we fall again, we'll make it through. I'll be there to carry you
over and over again. It's a fatal attraction, it's a little scary, but I got a plan of attack and I'll get us there someday soon. I know it, I got a plan A and I got a plan B, and if it's absolutely necessary, we'll go to plan C. Whatever I gotta do to be with you.
I don't want to wait for people to join before I just start singing. But happy Sunday. It's me, Joe.
All I want for Christmas is you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, everybody. My empty living room. We love her. She's the queen of Christmas. Don't look at me like that. I'm getting disapproving looks from Francisco over there. He doesn't want to make an appearance tonight. He's being very, I don't know, shy.
On with the show, please.
On with the show, please. Do you like our Christmas tree? Frankie did that. He's really good with the Christmas decor. And I think it fits perfectly in that little corner. I love it. Don't you love Christmas? To be completely honest with you, I didn't rehearse that much for this. I just was like, I'm just gonna pull up songs and we're just gonna like figure it out as we go. We're in this. Okay.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
Okay, I'm seeing a lot of Last Christmas. You guys, I've never even tried Last Christmas. So we're gonna go on this journey together because I know that you'll all be kind and it's not that serious. Something I'm trying to take into 2024 is that it's not that serious. I take myself a little too seriously sometimes. Someone said it's very serious. We will boo. That's so mean.
It's been a year, it doesn't surprise me. Merry Christmas. I wrapped it up and sent it.
You guys are funny. Christmas music. This, honestly, singing Christmas music, like, the best. Always cheers me up. Always feels warm in my heart. I definitely will have a Christmas album someday. It's just inevitable. Do it?
Do it.
Frankie's shouting from the other room. I got a new piano, a new keyboard, and I love it. It's the best. Okay. Ooh! Maybe the strings will be too much, but I don't give a shit. I don't care.
Oh, the joy of Christmas stays here inside us.
I, like, have a version that I like. Okay, wait. I'm getting up. I'm back.
Mixing a mingle and a jingling beats. That's the jingle bell rock.
Not Mistletoe by Justin Bieber. I mean, I love him. And I love that song. But hit me with some peanuts.
Christmas time is here.
I do love that. I mean, come on. This one, classic. No, I'm just glowing. I mean, it's a great song, but I'm just like, it's nothing that amazing, you know?
Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Make the Yuletide gay.
We just had, a Christmas contest talent show thing. And I sang this song there. I know, someone said you're getting whiplash from the songs. Me too. But it's, you know, it's not that serious. Okay.
This Christmas, the fireside is blazing bright.
Not food, but you know, a Christmas cookie is always good, you know. But I'm always eating cookies throughout the year, so it's not really like specific to Christmas, you know. I don't want to be sad right now.
Yay!
That's what my nephew would say. Yay! I don't know if I can say anything, but keep your eyes out for something in Atlanta very soon. Speaking of, first of all, Merry Christmas. If you're just joining, if you've been here, Merry Christmas if you haven't heard me say it yet. I have some fun stuff coming up that's not really announced yet, but that I just want to tell you to keep your eyes peeled for. Like maybe my first single maybe is coming out in the first month of 2024. I don't know. So keep your eyes out for that. And also I am going to be doing another concert in New York But that's not really announced yet either. So just keep your eyes out about that too. I hope you can come. And I think there will be a live stream of that too. So that will be fun. It'll be like this.
They know that Santa's on his way.
I will say, I feel way more in the Christmas spirit after this. So thanks for getting there with me. This is really fun. maybe this is all I need to do. Huh. Maybe I should do it earlier in December. Just so you know, those weren't official announcements. I just figured since you were sweet enough to be here, that you would get the special secret word. But get excited. It's gonna be fun. It's gonna be fun stuff. But I'm not ready to go. I'm just not ready to go.
Oh, that was hot. I'm scared to post that one because you'll win.
I'm taking everything I see as a sign, and I know it's crazy, but what if it's right? I'm here again, talking myself out of my own happiness. I'll make it up till I quit. I wonder if we should just sit here in silence, cause ooh, I think I talk too much.
Choosical, the
High School Musical, the
Choosical, yeah.
The Choosical!
Yeah. I was gonna say Choosical, the Musical.
So I think it's definitely a bittersweet. You wanna graduate and you wanna move on and you wanna go on to the next chapter of life, but also you're like, what are you, just like 5 more minutes?
5 years from now, Carlos will be standing in an open call for Wicked or like some like crazy new musical or something. Or maybe it's like High School Musical is actually going to Broadway. And he
that
is.
That would be perfect.
Yeah, he's in that open call.
And I couldn't have asked for a better person. And you're just going to have to see who we play in the show.
Absolutely.
I wonder.
One of my favorite memories is also one of my most traumatizing memories is I got everyone Tamagotchis, thinking that everyone was going to be responsible enough to keep them alive.
Well, give me a little
and
credit.
It was, yeah, Julia's just straight up went back to space.
Anyway, I'm not going to interrupt myself, but it's a hard topic.
That was one of my favorites because also like getting like yelled at. I was like, who bought everybody Tamagotchis? Because they beep.
And when you're on set, you have to be like silent. So there was just like a lot of beeping because a lot of feedings. By restraining or by law, I am not allowed near Zac Efron. So, you know, I did my best though. I tried.
I would say thank you so much for the best 4 years of my life. Thank you for the lessons. Thank you for letting me experience high school again, but in a musical form. And I had the best time.
I wish I was able to really have the confidence and the patience to pull off
nails like this.
Like just full on like long acrylics, but I know myself, I'd be like, I'm done.
Carlos and Seb are definitely in a Real Housewives episode. Before High School Musical, I remember I got the audition for it and I was like, yes, I will be there with bells on.
Maybe Joe?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Joe.
Or like a music director.
Yeah.
For
yeah.
Sure. Yeah. Always getting his shoulders rubbed.
Yeah.
He just goes like this.
I have no idea.
What does it really mean?
Are you playing with me?
Oh, you're trying to get us in trouble.
Carlos did have a birthday, but we don't know what month it landed in. So
it was cold. I'm going to say an Aquarius.
Hot.
He's an Aquarius. Middle name, Carlos Victor Rodriguez. And then favorite color, I feel like I wore a lot of green and blue. There's a lot of drama, but I think
one of the best things that came out of it is we get this great song that we got to preview earlier this year called Over Again that I get to sing with Joe Serafini. And so I was like, if Carlos has to go through this so that I can get this, I'll selfishly take it. I want to do something ridiculous. Like, Carlos made his way out to New York, but never made it. But like, never made it there. He currently resides in Las Vegas or something. Any day it turned into an impromptu like singing day. I think it was the end of season two. We all went upstairs where there was a piano and Joe Serafini got on the piano and then everybody kind of just sang a song. It was like almost like the perfect way to say goodbye to what was that experience. But those were always my favorite days because obviously everybody's so talented and everybody's so ready to sing, which I love. So those days were always very special.
I feel like I got a best friend for life. So... This has been an amazing experience.
I think I would pick Born to be Brave, assuming everybody knows the dance break. So that way, after graduation, you can throw your cap up in the air and then do the dance break.
Can you?
What? Barbie's World?
Dip in the pool, a trip to the spa, endless days in my shades, the whole world according to moi.
Excuse me.
Life in plastic, it's fantastic. Hey. I got one.
It's like sitting there on your phone listening to these like crazy professionals sing you a song or something that they wrote and like they'll ask, does this sound good? And it's the most amazing thing you've ever heard. Basically like my childhood dream come true.
Specifically, I Want It All is the number that I always go back on YouTube to watch because it's just so amazing.
I was doing a production of Peter Pan and everybody in the cast was gonna go to the movie theater to see High School Musical 3. And I remember I didn't have a ride and it almost didn't happen, but I'm glad it did. Face emoji where his head is exploding and he's like, and then it would be the emoji with the little hands where he's like this.
It would be the fire emoji and the winky with the tongue out emoji. It's now or never.
What? What was it?
Hi, I'm Cameron Cheats of Queerty, and I'm so thrilled to be joined by two of the stars of High School Musical, the musical, the series.
Like, oh no, it's really ending.
And of course, we were soaking it up every moment and just, yeah, there were lots of tears, but it's a really beautiful way that they wrapped it all together. Go ahead.
What would you say? Like,
what in terms of what?
I really don't want to give anything away.
So. Yeah.
it's lots of music. I mean, I don't know. You know, of course, I don't know. I can't give it away.
Yeah, it's like,
but, you know, I think so much of what musical theater, when we don't know, when we can't speak, we sing, yeah. Right?
Yeah.
And I, you'll see a bit of that.
We've been saying this since season one, but to get to be the representation we never really got to see on screen growing up and in, you know, a franchise that we all grew up with and were obsessed with, it's remarkable. And Joe just did a show out of town and he was gifted these letters that fans from all over the world had got given one person to give to Joe. And it was kind of amazing just to read those letters and see just your impact around the world. Cause we don't always really get to see that, but it was very touching.
Yeah. It's hard to wrap your heads around even 4 years into these characters, just the power of their existence on the screen to people watching at home. Like I think, we almost take it for granted in a way because we live in this big city where like, it's kind of, we're surrounded by people that are a part of this community. But like, you know, when you do go back to your hometown, that's a little smaller and it's just different when Carlos just are in a relationship. Like that's all it really is. Took too much from set. We had to donate some things. Yeah, we did take some stuff.
They were asking mostly about like clothes and small props. And I turned to Joe, I said, you should ask for the piano. And he was like, no, they'll never do it. I said, just ask for it. And he asked Tim Federle, our showrunner, for the piano. And
2 weeks after we wrapped, the piano showed up at our door. So we literally have the rehearsal room piano in this apartment now.
Oh my gosh, that's so cool.
It'll be with us forever. I think right now it's kind of like, we don't know what to do with it in our small apartment, but we hope to have it in a house someday where we can have the cast over and like everyone can play it. And, yeah. Can I tell them about
season one?
There was this one scene. I feel like it's been so long now that we can like laugh about it. One scene in season one. And he was upset with me about something. Can I tell them?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Oh, no.
I will always remember this day because I was just so like, oh my gosh, he's mad at me. And we had just started like dating at the time. And we were filming the scene and like we had to be in the scene. But then like, as soon as the cameras went down, like it was like silence. We were not speaking. Oh my God, he was upset with me. I know, drama. So I think that's a funny memory of like our early days of like, oh man, he was mad at me.
I do not remember
while
that.
We were at work, but no one would have known because we're so professional.
Of course.
No, making it a awesome
drama. Joe was always like the piano man. So I think anytime cameras went down and there was a piano in the room and Joe was able to bring everybody together to for like a big old singing moment. Those were always the best because everybody's so amazing. So the fact that they were just willing to do it for free, it was great.
I'm excited. I feel like it feels like almost like a fever dream because we went right into season three, into season four. So it kind of feels like this whole like whirlwind type thing.
Like I was not afraid to be like,
we did meet and greets.
But they were so gracious, so supportive of us and like just talk to us about anything and everything. They were awesome.
I'm like, there was a budget. There were, everything seemed bigger. And, so I would say the third one for me, it was wackadoodle time. And people were, it's funny for like when someone's trying to like out funny the next person. But I think one of my favorites are like any day we're trying to like scare each other or like, well, like if we just wrap a scene, someone runs ahead to like hide in the dark. So like, I mean, it's just stupid stuff like that. But I think
he has a lot of shenanigans. Hope that Carlos and Summer are still together.
Of course, but of course.
What about you, Joe? You know, Joe is a child star.
Oh yeah, Joe's a little.
Yeah,
we have
you guys too. Like the way seeing you guys like right in between things, or like like the creation that something that just comes from your brain, and then all of a sudden you're playing it on a piano, and it's like one of the most amazing things I've ever heard. That to me that's very inspirational.
Love it. I've been singing it around the house, and Frankie's like, "Stop singing it! I haven't heard it yet.
I don't want any previews. I want to listen."
That's the thing about her is like all her songs get in your head. Like they're so memorable, all of them. Looking for it right
if
now.
Not, I can sing it word for word.
So,
you don't even have to pull it up.
I'm trying.
I got a mic. I'm ready to go.
Oh yeah.
You know what, Joe? You can scram.
I've been dabbling.
What have you been dabbling in?
Share with the class
just a little bit, you know.
I started this year in one of my like New Year's resolutions, which is funny like to talk about New Year's resolutions in September.
But
it was one of my New Year's resolutions. I was like, I think I want to actually try writing this year. I think I've for so long just been like, oh, I don't know how to do it.
They're saying Joe's been cooking in the kitchen.
He has been cooking in the kitchen.
I have been. Really, it's been about just like the battles that I'm facing within my own head.
Right.
And just like, you know, believing in yourself and you know, trusting in yourself and your own abilities and stuff like that. But there's been some little love songs too and stuff like that that I've been...
Don't look me in the eye when you say that.
That I've been able to pull out. Yeah.
Wow.
And
Frankie, like you're... Like what's Frankie's
I feel
role?
Like I'm not good. Like if you were to ever ask me for notes on a song, that is so far from what I do. I would be like, it sounds great. Cause really like when any of you guys play me your songs for like the first time, I think it sounds amazing. And then yet you guys will go back and like keep adding to it and doing all of these things and then making it sound even more amazing. But it's been really cool to kind of just see the progression of one song and all of the work that goes behind it. I kind of thought you just like do a song in an hour and then it's done.
That is
apparently that's not how that works. No, but, it's awesome to get to see like the behind the scenes of the progression of a song and to hear the new added stuff.
Right.
I can't wait.
I don't know if I'm ready to share the title.
That's fair.
But I'll say that it's a very like empowering song.
Love it.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
It would be for us, Joe. Oh. I think it would be Rain on Me. Lady Gaga, Ariana Grande.
Who's who?
Of course, I'd be Ariana, obviously.
Okay. Well, if I get to be Lady Gaga.
Rain on me, soon on me.
Punch it, I see.
Well, if you need any dancers, you know where to find us.
How do you say? You kind of sound like Kelly Clarkson.
Oh my God, you're not the first person to say that.
I feel like, yeah.
No, I like singing, and I like belting, and I like, right. You know, just like bopping around.
I'm showing people that range.
Yeah.
I'm sure honestly. You're a pop star in your bedroom.
Yeah. Joe, I am a pop star.
Right. I witness it every day.
100%. Oh my gosh, I did everything, Adrian. I did trumpet. I did violin.
Really?
I didn't know this. I did clarinet. The one that stuck, though, was the cello. And I played cello for 4 years. And
like, you could bust out a cello piece.
If you gave me a cello right now, I couldn't even tell you the notes of the strings.
Oh, like, gone.
It is wiped from my brain.
No, what? I never knew that.
Yeah, I was first chair cellist for the last 2 years of high school.
You're lying. I had no idea. Joe, did you ever play any instruments that weren't
piano?
Yeah.
I was in the marching band and I played the bells, which isn't like bells like you ring a bell, but like a xylophone.
Right.
Yeah, like the mallets.
Yeah.
And I did that for 2 years.
I was in marching band too.
What did you play?
I played the mellophone.
Go off.
Not for long. That one didn't last.
The mellophone?
Yeah, the mellophone is the marching equivalent of the French horn. And then I was supposed to play the French horn in concert band, but I was like, I don't think this is for me. And
it
I peaced
really
out.
It's really difficult to play those instruments.
Yeah, no, it's not fun.
Like, those lips be working.
Yeah.
Yeah, some people, when people can play guitar, I'm like blown away.
Right?
Like
it's
when
insane.
Josh pulls out the guitar, he starts like, I'm like, wow, that's hot. It's fire. It's Frankie, learn guitar.
I will not be touching a guitar anytime in my life, I'll tell you that much.
On TikTok on my like burner, and I was scrolling through.
Wait, I want your burner account.
I'll
give you mine too.
Please.
We'll send each other TikToks.
And it's SeraFini, since you misspelled my name earlier.
Oh, wow. You know what's so funny? People have been saying on chat the whole time. They've been saying like, is Joe going to say anything about how Adrian misspelled his last name?
For you,
name?
Joe.
And yeah. I haven't. I just didn't say anything. I just didn't want to.
No, everyone misspells it. It's fine.
Even...
I can't talk about it.
You know what? YOLO. Okay. I'm doing backup dancing.
It'll be great though. No, because you guys will both be front and center.
Yeah, don't worry
like
about it.
Split 50-50 stage.
100%. As long as the check clears,
would you
I'm
do
there.
Some, are you doing some like crazy dancing?
Are you joking, Adrian? I'm a crumper. So yes, I will do it. Especially to Joe's music. It's the best place to crump.
Yeah. Oh. I want Joe to write a really sad ballad and I want you to like just crump to it.
Yeah, that one.
I'll send you the videos.
Joe's here too. He's blending in with the background. We said nail painting party and we really mean it. We're gonna have a party. Are you painting your nails?
Yeah.
Okay. Joe couldn't decide if he wanted to paint his nails or not, but he ended up giving him like midsummer.
No. End of summer's night's dream.
End of summer's midnight's dream. As you can tell, it just rolls off the tongue.
So, hi everyone.
This is Joe.
Kind of ate that up.
You did eat it. I'm almost done. You look stunning. Thank you. This is just my sin at home lurk. It's cuckoo bananas over here right now. That's like the best way to describe it. Probably the craziest it's been in a while. But you know what? I feel like so many chapters are like closing, specifically for like
our life and the things that we want to do and the things that we've done and the things that we're doing and the things that we will continue to do. But they always say when a door closes, another one opens, and the doors look really fun. So,
I love that.
Yeah, I'm really excited.
Too.
There's like a lot to be excited about right now, which, you know, is a nice feeling. I love looking forward to things.
Did you hear me?
What'd you say?
Did you have a superlative?
Superlative?
I did.
What was your superlative?
I had most likely to be famous.
Wow.
I had
Did you write it yourself?
No. What? They had a vote. And I had.
Did you vote for yourself? Be honest.
I don't think so. Okay. I don't think I could in good faith.
Yeah.
And I got cutest couple with my girlfriend at the time.
All right, we're gonna end the live.
I'm just shoving my hand.
I know, I love that. Thank you. Joe, I still need something a little more like that's gonna like
really?
Make me like when I like.
Do we have any song requests?
Last,
because
you know
he
mean?
Just tells me what. What he wants with like.
I Dua Peep is good. Dua Peep is a good choice. I just need something like it's a little more that's like, a little more like. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I need to.
Dang, somebody said they love my hair. Okay.
It's cute today. It's called Pearly Tops. What?
Sometimes I feel like I'm bullied into doing these things. But I have so much fun. Not coming for the dog, okay? Dogs are fine. I just think it's weird that there's a dog in there, and I don't like when the dog comes up and licks my leg, because then I'm just like, oh, hi. Do you know what I mean? I don't want the dog licking my leg. I don't know where that dog's tongue's been, but I'll tell you what, I can take one guess, okay? Again, don't come for me about the dogs, okay? I do not mind dogs. I think dogs are beautiful. I think dogs are great. If you're like on an outdoor patio eating lunch and you want to have lunch with your dog, I think that's the cutest thing in the entire world. When I go shopping or if I have like, if I'm getting a service done, like getting my nails done or getting my hair done or anything of that matter, I don't want the dog there. Do you know what I mean? And then also just like, aren't people allergic? Like, how do you know that like how can you just assume that everyone who comes into your establishment won't be allergic to dogs? I know, I kind of just get on this and kind of like bash dogs, right? I feel like that's what ends up happening on these things. But I really am here to tell you, I do not mind dogs. Like, I had two dogs growing up. I'm around a lot of dogs. And the dogs that let me be real. The dogs that are real with me, I'm real with the dog. That's like 100%. If the dog is just like, what's up? Hey, you can pet me, pat, 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 and then I'll go away. Or I wanna like lay on you. We're good. I don't like when the dogs are doing things that I'm like, we're not there yet. Don't lick my leg. Don't lick my toes. Don't jump on me. Anyways, that's just my spiel on that, and we can be done with that, because I feel like there's a really negative light being painted about me, about dogs. So, yeah, okay, anyways, no, I will get a dog at some point. I will have a dog in my life at some point, and I will love that dog so much, and that will be the most spoiled dog on the entire planet. Because it'll be my dog, and my dog will be so chill.
You. I think I'm done.
There's something on there. Let me see.
It's like something.
Wait. Joe, that literally looks like you didn't put anything on there.
I know. It's cute though. I mean, it looks like it's like a fresh, like, you know.
Invisible. That's honestly like a great like business tactic. They sold you nail polish with nothing in there.
Do you want to see it?
And you bought it and you put it on.
Are you enjoying Frankie's party? I brought snacks.
Joe brought invisible snacks. You know, I'm noticing a trend here. Joe's invisible, his nail polishes is invisible, his snacks are invisible. Is Joe real? What if Joe is an AI?
Who's to say?
Someday I'll tell you guys about my past. It's dark.
It'll be in the book.
It'll be my book. It'll be my memoir. Who Farted? A memoir by Frankie Rodriguez. It is what it is, Santa! In my two coats, it's pink, it's glitter, so it's shimmer. Cute. This real combo is makes me so freaking happy. Everybody's waiting for Joe. Joe, pop in the frame so everybody can say hi to Joe. There is Joe.
I'm excited.
Are you done with your thing?
Yes.
Joe, that is literally the funniest thing ever. You have a disappearing nail polish.
No, but there is like a shimmery aspect to it, which I am
Joe, there is
liking.
No shimmer to that.
No, there is.
Are you like the mattness of it? It is really nice.
The right angle. What do you guys think?
I can totally see it. It looks really good. Whoever keeps putting Who Sharted, an album by Frankie Rodriguez in the comments, you're getting blocked.
You are getting mustache right now.
Okay, if you want the truth, it's because the last time I shaved, I cut my lip. So I kind of had to like let it settle before I can. Don't say the mustache is mustaching. This took me 9 weeks, okay? Respect it. I ran across the street and almost got hit by a truck to meet Joe at JTF.
Oh my gosh.
Are you okay?
Well, that didn't happen.
That is so scary. Don't put yourself in risk.
Ooh.
Yes.
Whoa. That is stinky.
Well, you also put your whole nose in it, so. Joe, they really want me to leak stuff about your song.
What song?
The song's invisible too. That should be the name of your EP, Invisible. And you have no songs on there. You have like four, like eight songs. What do you click on it? Nothing plays.
I'll tell you about my song on my live when we do that.
Okay. I guess this audience isn't good enough.
No, I just, this is your moment, baby.
I guess we're not good enough to get
this
some.
This is your nail painting party.
Serafini's exclusives. Okay. Sorry, y'all. If any of you came here for a Joe Serafini exclusive, you might just want to exit the chat because it's not happening tonight. I'll tell you that much. Do we still say slay? What does Riz mean? What, Joe? Look up what Riz means.
I've looked this up before. I can't figure out how to use it in my daily life, though.
Okay, Riz! You got a Riz?
Do you have Riz?
Yeah, a lot of Riz.
I think so.
I hope so. Somebody asked if they can marry Joe. Who was it? Who was it? Put him on the live. Who was it?
Ducky. Ducky, ducky, what?
I love that.
Please! These gays! They're trying to murder me!
Salt air and the rust on your door. Never needed anything more. Whispers of are you sure? Never have I ever before. But I can see us lost in the memory. August slipped away into a moment in time. Cause it was never mine. And I can see us twisted in bed sheets. August slipped away like a bottle of wine. Cause you were never mine.
Sorry, I was late. I thought I had everything set up and then I just didn't have everything set up. This is like our last party of the year. Joe's here too, by the way. He's hiding. Do you want to say hi?
Hi.
Hi, y'all.
Oh, we're both giving green.
Oh, I never wear green.
When I started this year, I was like, I think green's my
You really have stepped into your green. Green looks good on you, though. You look like a minty, like a pastel type ish green.
But I also like a dark green. I like a olive green. I like green.
So you're saying you're obsessed with me?
Well,
just try not to spill anything on this table. Okay. Now. No, I'm good. Thank you. I think I have everything. If I spill something, I'll call for you. Okay. The school, as weird as the sound, the school does have a personality. Wouldn't you say, Joe?
Oh, yeah.
Like, it has, I don't know. It's really bizarre. It's a really cool place to, like, play and, like, be in. But, yeah, so I think if I were to go back 15 or, like, 20 years from now, I think I would definitely have, like, a weird, like, kind of reaction to it. Okay, Joe, you better manifest that reunion, okay?
Well, I mean, even if it's just, like, for fun.
That, for fun?
I mean, you know.
Yeah, I'm still looking for Zac Efron there. I'm like, where is he? The fact that we're all dressing up as zombies is funny enough. But it was just really funny because then after a while, you become, like, after seeing everybody for, like, by hour 8... it just starts to become normal. And then you're having like these really like backstage BTS conversations with people. And then you'll remember, you're like, oh yeah, you're a zombie. Like your teeth are like blacked out. But they told us, they were like, this isn't gonna hurt. So like, don't be scared. And we're like, oh, okay, yeah, great. It really hurt. So that was a lie. But it was just really funny because it just was like really sharp and like kind of scary. So. Yeah, it did look amazing. But if you watch it, you can see I kind of laugh at the end. Because it was really funny. So like if you bought, like wait till like the last second, you can see me laughing. Spoiler!
Would you like a cup of tea?
Oh, I'm okay, thank you. Okay, I'm all over the place. I don't know, it really did feel like Halloween. So, and I love Halloween, so. Okay, progress report.
It also was Halloween.
It was Halloween. That's a strange.
So it was fun for us, but when it came out, it was August. We do always do that on the lives.
Oh, okay. I didn't know you had a problem with it. Somebody just asked, how are you? Thank you. I really appreciate it. Hi, Joey. Everybody say hi.
Say hi back.
Like today, I have been wanting... Why, don't laugh at me!
I'm laughing at today on the subway.
Okay, today on the subway, here's what happened. So I try to avoid the subway at all costs. If it's like 40-ish minutes away, I'll try to walk. I'm like, I'll get my steps in, it'll be fine. But it is so cold right now that I've been taking the subway. And so, and also when I get on the subway, I'm usually with Joe, who is like 100% the navigator. And I just like kind of follow around like a little baby with like, I'm just like, you know, I can just hear my brain rattling in my head, which is great. I love that. But on my way back, I went Christmas shopping today. And I've been talking about how I've been wanting to go to the holiday markets for like, since like the announcement thing. And so, but it hasn't worked out. We tried to go this weekend and it was just so many people. So I was like, let's just come back like later. And so I was supposed to get off on a specific street and like the subway car just like drove past it. And I was like, what does this mean? But then it just spit me out in the middle of the holiday market that I've been wanting to go to. So I was like, this is New York, you know what I mean? Not to like be dramatic or anything, but like, I think it's the greatest musical of all time. Why are you laughing at me?
I agree. Bop after bop.
And it is bop after bop. And Usher actually came up to Joe and was like, if you don't stop singing, we will have to take you out of here. And Joe is like in full costume, like full dress, like painted green. And I was like, please, sir, please don't do that. He's never been to a Broadway show before. This is in what? What happened?
Someone sent a heart or something. It was like a
people are always sending me hearts, Joe. Something you should know. Okay, I'm gonna focus. Will you keep them entertained for like 3.5 seconds? Because I'm gonna.
Can I answer a question?
Answer a question. Yeah. Answer that one. Oh wait, no, we already answered that one. Oh, wait, answer that one.
You do your nails.
Do you? Somebody said my favorite artist is Joe Serafini. Same. Same. Oh, what was your Spotify Wrapped? I'm too embarrassed to say. Feliz, and also, might I just add, Feliz Navidad did not come up on anybody's Spotify Wrapped. What's up with that? That is a classic. What the heck was that? Yeah. Favorite duet to sing with Joe? Obviously, the song from Dear Evan Hansen is a go-to for us. We're always looking for more duets to sing. There aren't a lot of that dog. There aren't a lot of boy duets to sing together, so we struggle with like finding those things. So if anybody has any recommendations, you know, we love the musical theater, all that stuff. So if you have any recommendations of some duets, we love just singing some stuff, but it really is hard to find two boy songs that aren't like boring. Over again. This question is haunting. It says, what do you plan on doing since HSMT MTS is over? Wow, that hit so hard. A boo, a ghost. And tell me if I'm saying this wrong, Joe, but white gardenia? Gardenia?
Gardenias,
white gardenias. It's like a little old lady, it's a little old lady-ish, but like a, that is probably my favorite scent ever. It just smells so nice and clean and fresh. What is your thing? What is my thing? Like just in general, like that, That's let me get back to you on that one. Who's taller, you or Joe? I think we're exactly the same height. I don't think one of us is taller. Which is great.
We would know.
The song playing. I don't know. Charlotte, I'm sorry. It's so early in the morning. It's 2 a.m. I'm sorry. Who is your best friend? Myself. And obviously, it would be
Trilogy.
What that means? Doesn't that mean like trilogy, like 1, 2, 3 trilogy? Yeah. Like
so the movies. So it's explained.
What these things mean? Double's homecoming episode air date is 4 years old tomorrow. That is crazy. It just seems like yesterday, but it also seems like 28 years ago. How do you always slay so hard? This is a great question. Slaying hard is, every day comes with its challenges. Challenges I don't always, I don't always conquer. Saturday and Sunday rolls around, we have the idea to go do something really fun that's been on the list, but so does everybody else in America. So then we get there and it's just like people on top of people. Like, you think I'm kidding? There's like people stacked on top of people. It's insane. Sushi Cat is here in New York City. We packed them in a little box and they made it here. But Joe didn't want to bring Sushi Cat and I was like, we have to bring Sushi Cat.
We were being very, very ambitious about what we were taking and not taking.
That's true. Moving across the country, you can't exactly take every single thing that you want because we didn't know the type of space we were gonna have here and like the storage situation. But Sushi Cat is a little baby.
We have to brought her.
Them, Joe.
I'm glad we brought them. I just didn't,
Okay.
I was trying to be frugal.
But always take a pair of fuzzy socks. Are we done with them? Do we want more of them? Oh, okay. So, oh, you go. Thank you. Okay, we'll do more. This is not a question, but you should definitely leak Joe's song. I have no idea what you're talking about. Can you and Joe adopt me? No. Is there anything else I'm missing, Joe, that we really loved?
Like show?
Not to be so cliche, but I really love rainbows. Because I love a can of Pringles, are you joking? I always love my wrapped gifts, but you know, that's that. Thanks, Joe. Okay, everybody's just demanding me sing over again. I haven't sang that song in forever. Tips on asking out a friend. No. I am not good at that stuff.
No?
Not on asking out. I mean, I don't think I have, like, any, like... I'm, like, good once it's going, but I'm not, like, a good, like... I'm not, like, that type of person. Do you know what I mean?
I shared my feelings first.
Okay, we're not gonna go there, okay? I came to say hello. Where have you been? Hey, y'all. Beautiful time of the year.
We were just cowboys.
Okay, Joe, cliche. I guess homecoming? That was pretty fun. Will Joe post more singing TikToks? We miss him.
I'm so sorry, you guys.
Yeah,
we
Joe.
We moved here.
Yeah.
We were sick.
Oh, yeah. We had come back
and
to
then,
COVID.
And it's just been busy. I mean, New York is different. Different beast.
In LA, you have a car. And, like, you get to just drive around. And sometimes your car needs maintenance. It needs a car wash. It needs... new brakes, it needs an oil change. Here, you are the car. And you are, I'm breaking down all the time. I'm like, my knees hurt, my ankles hurt, my toes hurt, my teeth hurt if it's cold. But we're having a really great time, so thank you for asking.
What type of tea do I have? I have, this is Moroccan mint tea with a teaspoon of honey in it. From Trader Joe's.
Okay, somebody said...
grocery store. I am Trader Joe's.
I wish you were Trader Joe's. We'd be living in a very different apartment if you were Mr. Trader Joe's. I'll tell you that much right now. One is home and one is New York City. You know, it's just like a place to like come and do some cartwheels.
Are you gonna do all of them?
I think so. This one just says, Joe Serafini, your boyfriend?
Yes.
How many times do we...
What more do we have to do to tell you?
When will you get it?
How many more photos do you need to see of us together?
Okay, this one's funny. Were you actually looking at a photo of Joe Serafini in that hallway scene? Okay, no. When you're filming something that's going to be put in later, you're usually just looking at a green X. Now, that's where I fumbled the bag because the man who does props was really nice and asked me, he said, hey, is there any chance I can get photos of you and Joe just like doing everyday things so we can put it in the montage when they're going back? And I was like, yeah, totally. He was like, great, just have it to me by, and he gave me like a great amount of time to get those photos in. I did not get those photos in. So the photos that they chose were photos from prop phones.
Which
so
are horrible photos. Literally, I mean, like,
so that's my fault. I'm sorry.
That's so mean.
Joe did not paint his nails this time around. Guess it's too good to paint his nails, so. But.
Sorry. I'm saying bye.
bye, Joe. What if Joe just, like, left and then I never saw him again? I would always wonder what happened to him.
young lad.
I wish.
The house in the world you never thought to explore.
It's not the ending, Joe.
I had one job.
There it goes.
I'm glad you're not playing the bank.
Whoa!
Whoa!
And turn it.
Oh, come on.
Oh,
throw it and flip.
You can definitely have a celebrity cameo in it.
Look, look. I saw where Haley was, so I had to come up and just say hello.
Serafini. Hi, guys. Thank you so much.
Good morning.
Time.
Oh, my gosh. It's so special. It very much feels like a homecoming. And just to be back where I started, but in this new space in my life, has been really special.
Oh, I love that.
I do. All right, Carolee, tell us a little bit about the musical for those who have never seen it before. I mean,
the dead, have to go the way. Have a straight.
Hi, everybody.
It's act two. I have a long break. You can't rest for too long during the show. You'll lose your mind. Oh, there's the giant. Oh man, we have it. Toss, toss.
We are not responsible for the
like Glinda. Do you guys like my outfit? I really love this vest. It's kind of giving. Cinderella. I know, just making eye contact with her, I'm like.
Yeah.
That's outside.
That's the worst music I've ever heard.
Into the Woods, I know you always say that one.
Yeah.
Perfectly Blonde.
So like, yeah.
That's what my first viewing was too.
So good, so good.
Hi everybody, watch me dance, dance the night away. Not me jumping the gun, I got excited. Woo! Rivers belong where they can ramble, eagles belong where they can fly. I've got to be where my spirit can run free. Gotta find my corner of the sky. Oh, thank you guys. I'm so glad you're all here. Not that I'm a sponsor for Wicked, but I might as well be. But I'm going on Sunday night, and I cannot wait to be there and witness it. The last time I saw it on Broadway was when I was a kid, and now I just moved to New York, spoiler alert. And now it's gonna be one of the first Broadway shows I see after moving to New York, so I'm very excited about that. We'll see what happens, but I hope we will never be apart. Oh, hypothetically, yes, theoretically, forever. Now let me actually say this. I sang this song in college at in a class setting. We were doing like a unit on singing in a cabaret setting, so it's only fitting that I sing it now. But I remember I was dating someone at the time, and I was singing it kind of like with them in mind. I even like made eye contact with them in the crowd, and then the week later they broke up with me. So really, really great juju with this song. Lately I seem to walk as though I have wings, bump into things like someone in love. And I wanted to sing Giants in the Sky for you all tonight. There are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. And I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. Still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. All right. So, I have a microphone over here, so I can just do this. Oh, wait. All right. I'm gonna take this with me. So, I did just move to New York with my boyfriend, Frankie. And yeah, we're just really excited about that. That's been a new adventure for us.
I don't have any reasons. I've left them all behind. I'm in New York, state of mind.
So I noticed my shoe wasn't tied. So we got to New York City. October 1st, and I was so eager and so excited to hit the ground running and see all my friends and start hustling. And then literally not even a week into our arrival, we got COVID and got sick, and we had to take a whole week of not leaving the apartment in this new city that I moved into. And as eager as I was to get going, the universe was forcing me to slow down.
Slow down, you crazy child. You're so ambitious for a juvenile. But then if you're so smart, then tell me, why are you still so afraid?
So, I want to get to know you. Questions and like, okay, come on. So we do want to talk. All right, come on.
Not effing with cats. Can I have Cole back up here? Where did he go? Did he quit? He's back! Everyone give it up for Cole. This is what I see. This is love to me. She's a woman, so I love women. I think that's when I realized I might be a little bit gay. Do you love me? Do you love me, baby?
Oh, I think that was your last song. Yeah, you're gonna leave now. I'm taking over. Okay. Yeah. Water this whole time. I'm very impressed with myself.
Okay. You and I.
I've been wanting to make my own original music for quite some time now. And it's always been on my mind, but I just didn't really know how to start. And I kind of just kept making excuses for myself. But I finally got my shit together. And I asked for help. And then I guess I wanted to tell you that I can't share it with you yet. I was gonna maybe sing it, but I'm not. I'm sorry. I just don't want you to hear it and then, you know, like not be into it when it comes out in a couple months, you know? I won't give it away too soon. Gotta tease you a little bit. This is The Climb.
There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it a move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. Ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side. It's the climb. Morning when you wrap me up, I know that forever could never be enough. I feel it in my body, know it in my mind. Oh, I'm gonna love you for a long time. I'm gonna love you for a long time.
Thank you.
Tricked ya!
Well, the sky is finally open. The rain and wind stop blowing. But you're stuck out in the same old storm again. Thank you guys so much.
Okay, bye! I'll see you at karaoke!
How do I know if people are on here? Maybe I should have watched that tutorial. Hi. Hi, King. Hi. Joey's here too. He's on the opposite side. The setup was interesting because you guys wanted me to stop sitting on the floor, and then I started to get stressed out. So we have like one corner of our room that we can do this in. So that unfortunately means Joe's on the opposite side. But
I'll come say hi.
He's going to come say hi. There's Joey.
I forget, what's the word?
Iridescent?
Not iridescent.
Sparkly. It's... Future.
No, there's a word for it.
What are you trying to say?
I'm gonna find out.
Okay, I'm gonna start. And give me like
all the graphic! Yes, what they're saying.
Okay, don't yell at me. Oh my God.
Thank you.
I feel like I've been having a moment of like self, being self proud. Is that a, Joe, help me out with a big word.
Prideful?
Prideful. Loving myself, yes. I've been in an era of really loving myself and accepting myself where I am. And right now I just want to sit on the couch. I'm not going to feel guilty about it. Oh, wait, let me see.
It's pretty fun. Well, I think it's going to dry different.
Oh, that's cute though.
Because my color is blue.
No. If you want Joe, you pay for Joe. Joe's in his TikTok flop era. So if everyone after you watch this, if you can go, please show some love and support for Joe Serafini. He really needs it. If this TikTok fails, we might not get another one. Okay? For the past 6 to 18 months, I've done nothing but sit on the couch. And I'm not going to apologize for it. I'm having a great time. So just let me live.
That is so not true though. You've been doing a lot.
You guys need to be on Broadway. Thank you. You're right. Frankie, Sebla's duet exists. It does. Season 4 of High School Musical, the musical, the series, will be out anytime between now or 2035. Hoping it's this year, but if I have children by the time it comes out, I would not be surprised. Oh, let's see it, Joey.
I think I'm loving it.
Oh, wait, I want to see.
I mean, it's very...
I like it. I like the little silver sparkles. Can I steal Joe? No, Joe, get out of here. Frankie, I'm seeing Beyonce. Same. I mean, I will see her this big, cause our seats are in space, but, I'm excited. Somebody just said I'm their favorite performer of all time.
Wow.
I should take this on the road. Frankie, do you have plans for June? The whole month? Oh my God. It's a long month. If you guys want to see Joey as Jack in Into the Woods in Pittsburgh, I would do that.
Recommend?
Yes, I would recommend that. Somebody in the chat said, is it true you're replacing Leah Michelle in Funny Girl? Who told you that? I don't read. Are you and Joe a couple in real life? We've thought about it. We're still thinking about it, you know? 4 years then. Oh, Joe reads, actually, so Joe can blow through a book so quickly. Joe, what's your favorite book?
I'm in the middle of a hand. What's the last book I read that I loved?
I like it. You're also doing a good job.
So cool.
No, I think it's good. Sometimes I just feel like I put my hands down and they just bang every finger with a hammer. He threw like roses in the water. I got like a coffee and like champagne. I was like, what did I just pay for? And I have to be quite honest, I might take this off before tomorrow.
No, you like it.
I wanted something more pink because my outfit is so pink. I don't want to say I'm doing God's work, but when I went to the beach as a kid, we were playing in the water and I felt something touch my leg and I looked down and it was a blackbird like this, like it was humongous and it was dead in the water. I'm sorry if there are children on this live, but there was a dead bird in the water and it was disgusting. That bird probably could have like eaten me alive. I also love a theme party.
We may have some matching elements.
And Joe says we might have some matching elements. So, I can make something. And then I asked my mom about it and she said, you can't do that. I was like, okay. So I have to believe her. Say something in Spanish. Hola, ¿cómo estás?
It's not funny, it's just funny.
Okay.
You're just funny.
Thanks, Joe.
I'm on my second coat.
Oh, okay. Give me a second. Just pause the live second. Hold up, hold on. I'm a sucker for a rainbow. I know it's like marketed towards me, but I'm like, I love it. I don't care. Island girl, Hawaii. Ooh, why is Joe so mean? I don't know, Mo. I don't know. He makes me cry. Let's play some basketball. Freaky.
I'm not mean.
Now I'm like a stand-up comedian, and I'm just like, oh my god, and it's exhausting. So I don't want to make it about me, but let's make it about me.
It's,
let me see.
It's giving something.
Let me see.
Here.
Okay, that's honestly a sleigh.
It's pride, you know?
Joe, you ruined Sophie's birthday song.
I'm so sorry.
Oh, Joey Serafini.
Oops. Who's the better cook?
Me. I'm not cooking anything. I can order something though.
You're coming to see Into the Woods?
Into the Woods.
I can't wait. I'm so excited.
That's Joe Serafini, everybody. Joe, you should have like a musical segment on this. Like we should like, while we're waiting for our nails to dry, like you.
How could I play the piano while I'm waiting for
that
my nails
is not
to
something
dry?
For me to figure out. That actually sounds like it's something for you to figure out. Frankie's fab fingers. That makes it sound like they're chicken fingers. Oh, no, Ari.
Not chicken fingers.
I love a chicken finger. Don't get me wrong. I don't like. I don't care where we go. I don't care if we're in the finest establishment. The first thing I'm looking for is chicken tenders and fries. Tell them, while I do this, give them a fun fact.
A fun fact?
I'm always like, I've never broken a bone. Watch tomorrow, I just get hit by a car.
A fun fact of mine is that I grew up with a dog. And at the end of her life, we had to remove
Joe, don't
her eyes.
Joe, don't say that story. That's... Oh my god, that's not a fun fact. A fun fact is like, I know how to do a backflip and front flip. Not we removed
okay.
My dog's eyes. Oh my god.
A fun fact is that I'm a lefty.
Somebody said that's a sad fact. That is a sad fact, Joe. That's not a fun
Wait,
fact.
Wait, I literally have a note in my phone that says like, when people ask for an interesting fact, say this.
The last person I really want to be right now in life is the person that's like, oh my gosh, can you do me a huge favor and watch my dog? And this is, I'm just speaking truth here. And if you have, no one wants to watch your dog. No one wants to watch your dog. If you are a person with a pet, no one does. We were almost attacked by birds. And it was disgusting. I don't know if you've seen a bird up close, especially ones from the beach. They're disgusting. This straight up is gasoline on my nails.
Gasoline?
Why did Joe look like Ed Sheeran? Well, I don't know if you know this. Joe actually is Ed Sheeran. He just performs under a pseudonym.
Oh, he does a top coat. I actually like it, Frankie.
Thank you.
It's okay if I'm buying it because I can do it again when we
That's
get to see
right, Joe. You justify that purchase.
I was like, I have more than one opportunity to use this.
So.
Mariah Carey's also performing.
At WeHo Pride?
I think so.
What was the budget? The hair is herring. Thank you.
I know, your hair does look good.
Thanks. It's a wig.
What's your favorite color?
Pink. I can also do a cartwheel. And I can dab. And you can't hear that, but my neck did make some noises when I did that just now, so.
Never dab again.
I don't know who said that, but you're getting blocked.
A lot of them said it.
I'm blocking everybody. We want to see a cartwheel. I don't really know if I can do it here. I don't know if I have enough space. Joey, you're not gonna move stuff so I can do a cartwheel. It's gonna be really fun.
Your favorite song that you're embarrassed to say is your favorite song.
I'll tell you after this live. I'm not gonna, because you know they will roast me. You know they will really roast me. They came for me for my dab. They came for me. They come for me. And when I'm just like, be nice.
Actually, have Frankie paint my nails because he does a really good job. Have I been to Necto? Of course.
What is that? What is that?
It's a club in Ann Arbor.
Oh my gosh! Please do not bring up Michigan. We went a whole hour without talking about where Joe went to school.
My eyes are blue.
So,
thanks for joining.
Joe's trying to coach. Joe's like a stage mom in the corner being like, sign off, Joey.
Bye, y'all. It was nice to chat with you all.
How do I get out of here?